But another thing that nobody seems to ever think about and pay attention to on these 30-year loans, so just not even thinking about how your interest rate is much lower, another reason here to really pay attention to is on a 30-year amortization. If you ever actually pull up an amortization schedule, and if you've never looked at one or never looked at an amortization calculator, I have them on HoltonWiseTV.com. It's free. It's like the tools section. But if you ever actually look at it, all of your interest is pretty much packed, like jam-packed at the beginning of a loan. Like loans, 30-year loans, like industry-wide on average, typically only last between 4 and 7 years. Like owner-occupants typically sell their houses every 4 to 7 years. I think it's like 7 is like for owner occupants, and then like small rental properties actually trade even faster. But like, let's just call it around 7. Okay. Cause most loans on properties like this are owner occupied, but lenders have set this, the game up, right? Where they know, okay, it's a 30-year loan product, but it's probably only going to last for 7 years. So if you actually look at your amortization schedule, like all of your interest and stuff, it's like way packed, right?
And $100 to principal.
Yeah, right. But it's less. No, it's like less, right? Like, I mean, if you really look at it, like sometimes, like I know sometimes I review them, like obviously the numbers are a little different because a lot of the properties that we're dealing with out here are around the 100K range. But like if you have properties where like the mortgage and stuff is like 1,000, okay? But in that 1,000, it's going to also have your escrow for your insurance. And it's going to have your escrow for your taxes and whatnot. But like literally of a $1,000 mortgage payment in the first 7 years of that 30-year note, you're literally getting like $7 to $9 going towards your principal, right? So you've already passed that 7-year hump. You're at like your 9 or 10 now. So now you're really getting into the good stuff, right? So not only is your property going to appreciate like crazy over the next couple, 20, 30 years or whatever, not only is your interest rate for that 300K that you've borrowed half of what you could borrow a different 300K, you're at the point now where like you're really starting to chunk away at the note. So like, that mortgage itself is like a huge asset. So like I forbid you to sell this property and use the money to buy any type of rentals in Cleveland. Like this should be like this is probably your best asset. And this should be like the foremost asset of your portfolio going forward. Cause like I could sell you a bunch of stuff in Cleveland that I could turn around and sell to anybody else. Okay. What you have is a property with 500K of equity at a point in your loan where you're paying off principal, at a point where your loan is half the cost of a different loan. Like this is something that I could not turn around and sell to another human being, nor could any other broker, right? Like you have something that is no longer able to be purchased in 2023. So like, this is like a really, really good thing. So keep this thing, keep it. Right. And if you need to free up capital, just do a cash out refi. Right. Because you got freaking 500K sitting there. And then you also need to pay capital gains taxes on accessing that 500K. So if you ever need cash, do a refi. But like this should be the last property that you sell.